Okay, let's get set up a little bit better here. Let me turn some more lights on. I started to do this earlier, and I got a package, which I will show you in a moment. Okay, newbies, it's out. Oh, no, actually, I want it to be like right there. I'm going the wrong way again. Jeez. There. It should be okay, I think. Okay, let's move that out of the way. Important to know, not only, of course, do you want good business, everybody else wants good business too, but everybody don't do good business. This is the second box I got like this. I'm starting to like these. What is that? 8x6x2. That might be enough for two pair of fat earrings, huh? I have to look into buying those. You know, you don't want to be taken advantage of. No one does. However, even on Etsy, I haven't had the problem on eBay, thank God. But on some Etsy shops, well, anyway, this is not about that, so I'll just stay focused. You always want to make sure you give what you get. And when you get good, you want to let that person know. So this is from Yandanabeads on Etsy. Okay? Look at that nice packaging. I think this came in 3 days. So she's in Tracy and I'm in San Jose. So yeah, but even sometimes I order stuff from San Francisco and it takes, you know, 3 weeks to get. On occasion, I have ordered stuff from China. Rarely. Don't write to me about that. And even from there, it only took 8 days. Yeah, I was shocked. I was really shocked. Okay, we'll leave that over there. I might want to use their label paper someday. I'm not being sarcastic. I'm being funny because I'm surprised I didn't think of that. Okay, there's our goodies. Nicely wrapped. Nice box. It was well protected. You know I love that. Okay, so let's see what we've got. Who was I talking to the other day? Oh, I was talking to William. William, you remember we were talking about this piece? Yeah. So, yeah, my little niece was bored, so she kind of got happy. We were talking about, you know, wrapping this piece, you know? So this is what I really had in mind for that piece outside of even wrapping it and adding some stones on top of it. Kind of, sort of, but not like this. I take little bits of everything and glue it together because piezoelectric properties are really good for us too. Glue on stone is not a bad thing, okay? So, my other thing I was going to do with that, hang on, got to be organized, stay organized. Bubble wrap goes there. That goes there. And I got this gorgeous That's Marcy, okay? Yelling. And praise God, we still ain't got no snow. Beautifully packaged. 16-inch strand of deep blue agate faceted. And normally, I don't like faceted stuff unless I'm making a Shambhala bracelet or something. Yes, I keep that. Let me put that away. But isn't that gorgeous? And I would actually like these two together. I'll have to wait and see if she wants these two together. Let me take a picture real quick. Because what I really want to go back to, you see how beautiful this is, by the way. Sorry. You know me, I get really chatty and off topic after a minute. Well, okay, not usually. I'm usually pretty organized with my notes posted next to, gotta find the right light. Hang on. Okay, that looks pretty good. Yeah, usually I'm very organized. But I was thinking I would put these two together. See, and even this is really, it wasn't just my camera this time. Because see, you guys wonder whether a lot of the color comes from? It's because I have a red camera that takes really great pictures, thank God. So often that's what you see in the camera, but not this time. That's really little twinges of red and blues. See, and if you look on the outside of this, let me zoom the camera. If you see on the outside of that, right there, it is really, 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 oh, it has a hole. Oh, didn't notice that. Sorry. Blue. And so, like, right here, I know you can't see it good, so you got to go on Facebook and there. And look at the picture there. See, that's got a nice little twinge of something else in it. Purple, reddish color. And a lot on this side. So I was thinking about putting those two together. So somebody already said that they wanted this already. So I'm going to see what she wants. Okay, now I got some purple faceted agate. 16 inch. And I think I paid, I don't know, $4 for each of these. Look at that. Isn't that some nice, beautiful, there we go, purple. Look at that. No, it's not amethyst, it's purple agate. You gotta remember to read your colors, to read your sizes, okay? So the lesson in this is open the package, take pictures, you know, right away or something. I started doing this 100 years ago because one lady didn't believe me, and I'm like, why would I lie about a strand of beads? Go look at my receipt. That's the main thing that got me really liking Etsy back in the day, was because it has my very first order on there. Yes, it does, you know, and that was what, 10, 12 years ago? I really like that. And then everybody else started doing it too, which is nice, but you don't have my very first order when I want those little he-she, hi-she, whatever beads. But they were thick. They were a good, oh, I don't know, maybe 2 millimeters thick and 3 millimeters in left and right. You know what I mean. So, and I think I got two. Yep, I got two of these. Is that what's on my thing? Yes, it is. And these, of course, these little ones I like to use as, where am I? As, in between the big beads. Sorry, I can't think right now because I'm too excited about what I'm about to show you. Separators. I will leave these in that because what I'm going to do is... Okay, newbies, let me back up. Oops. What I'm going to do is... And of course, I'm not left-handed, so just... understand. Okay, so I'm going to hold it by the tail and leave the rest of it in there. And then I'm going to, where am I? Oh, my finger's covering it. Sorry. Anyway, I'm going to just cut the string in the bag. Don't pull the string out. Okay, see, then I take some off and try to find the other end of the string in the bag. So they don't go all over the floor. Lord knows I have enough beads on the floor already. Okay. So I'm just going to take some of those off. Turn the string to the other side. put that string back. Now you got to remember, you can't just like turn it loose. Okay? And you pull just a little, just a little, just a little. So the one is, they're coming off in the bag, not over your top index finger. See? And they're all separated in one bag, ready to use. Next. Because see, sometimes, if you only have two hands and not the little grabber handle thing that's on a little tripod, you know what I mean, with the magnifying glass in the mirror. I have one of those in a box. Yeah. Ugh, can't wait to move. Living in a box is not my idea of a good time. Appreciative. Got a roof, got food, got people that love me. Okay, which side is going to come off? Oh, come on. Which side are you? There you go. Well, scoot your butt down. Scoot your butt down. Scooch, scooches, scooches. And you make sure you leave it in the bag. Don't get excited. You can't turn your head. You can't sneeze. Because poof. Yeah, I did that a few times. That's why I make these videos. So you know how to do that. Oh, how funny. It wasn't funny then, but it's funny as hell now. Scooch. Papa bought a whole bunch of groceries today. Oops, I'm sorry. I'm being off topic. Sorry. I'll save that for another video. Seeing you and just scooch, scooch, scooch. I love her beads. I love her prices. I love her good service. And thank God she wasn't one. But I even told her, I said, hey, you know, I ordered two strands. Oh, I left one. I ordered two strands of blah, 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 blah. Okay, cool. Next day, it was here. Seriously. Now, even from Tracy to San Jose usually takes even priority 3 days. You know. And I like her because if I have a question or anything, she answers me right away, like within 2 hours. I'm still waiting for a response 2 days for this one person. And I'm sorry. Excuse me. You might, this is green jade. And what I do, because it looks like amethyst, right? Looks like amethyst. Or it looks like a lot of things. Excuse me. So I'm just going to get a piece of tape, because you know you can't just write on baggies. I'm going to put that there. And then I'm going to write on it. Green jade. Then that's, after that dries, it's not going to smudge or come off or nothing. So I told her, and she sent me my stuff right away. Right away. Okay, see, this is a harder thing than fish wire. So sometimes it'll and come out and you won't. Yeah, so that's why I usually just wear a dress. And I just pour these out in my dress. Okay, I'll take that one off later. Port my dress and then put them in there. Get rid of that guy. I don't have any use to recycle that as of yet. Though, you know, I try to find ways to recycle everything. Yes, I do. See, and I just put them back in my bag. And then, you know, that's not aventurine. Or aventurine, as some people call it. Oh, shoot. Where's my glasses? Whatever. I'll just keep cutting till I get it right. And this lady is very, very, very wonderful. I like her a lot. Well, I've never met her, but I like her service. I like her prices. I like her shop. It's always full. Have nothing to worry about. See, where you can cut it in the middle like that and then turn it over. Okay, that's gonna take too long. Come on. And there you have it. And don't forget, you have to, you know, treat yourself fair. You know, yeah, everybody doesn't make videos, but you know what? I gotta market myself. I may as well market you too, especially if you're good. I do not even say boo to those people that are not kind. Oh, that's what I was gonna tell you. Okay, so, and this is just me. Don't write to me about it, because I don't care about your opinion. To me, I was raised... Okay, I know you guys have probably heard this before, and Yananda, this isn't anything about you, so this is just a little side thing for my my channel. So, I had gone to my brother's funeral. Yes, my older brother went home at, what, 1990? Let's see, Tupac died in 96, so he went home in 94. So my mom and I were at the funeral. And so let's say you called, I don't know. Anyway, I had a call for interview Monday. This was a Friday. I didn't think, yeah, it's cold here. Chilly, no snow, no snow. So I had, the funeral was on a Friday. I had an interview that next Monday. So, you know, I've got to multitask. So, I'm talking, I did say I'm talking to you on the phone. I'd be like, hey, Barbara, you know, this is Tasha. I'm at my brother's funeral. I might be, you know, needing to reschedule. And she gives invoices. I love invoices. I really do. Because you know what? If the computer goes down, my cell phone is broken. So I don't have a cell phone right now. So I can't just hit that E and see what I ordered. Blah, blah, blah. So yeah, I love my invoices. Thank you for taking the time to print these out. Yandanabeads. Yandanabeads. All one word. Thank you. I appreciate this. See, so I'm going to put that over there and file that. So I always have it. So you guys, sorry, I try really hard not to do it because I don't like people doing it to me, but I'm kind of lazy about uploading these long videos because it takes sometimes two or three hours, especially if you don't save it as an MP4. Anyway, so I was at my brother's funeral and my mom overheard my conversation, and don't you know, she took that phone. Hello, Brenda. Hi, Brenda. Yeah, this is Mrs. Harris. Uh-huh. And, yeah, I overheard my daughter say she might not make it on Monday. She'll be there. She hits me. Yes, and she'll be on time. Yes, uh-huh. Okay, she'll see you on Monday, honey. Okay, bye-bye now. I'm like, Mom, why are you hitting me? And all these people are looking. And we're at the funeral, and everybody's, well, other people are crying. Me and my mom don't do that crying stuff, because we're happy to see them go home. Not selfish. You can go home and talk to me just as good from the other side as you are, ooh, sitting here. So, you don't ever, ever, ever do bad business. That's bad for business, and you knew it. You knew you had to go there 2 weeks ago when you put it in your calendar. There is never any excuse for not doing good business, no matter what it is. If you're doing it for yourself, if you're working with somebody, or if you're going to an interview. Oh, man, she thumped me on my head. I was so embarrassed because, I mean, I was grown. I mean, I'm like, I don't know, 40, I think. So I said that to say, yeah. And even me and one other girl got, well, she got in a fight. I didn't get no fight because it's just business. I mean, my grandma died too. My uncle died too. My brother died too. My other brother died too. My lover died. My other lover died. I mean, come on. I was still there. So to me, that's just an excuse. You can show up and be present now and then go home and go back to crying. I'm not even sorry. No. Ain't gonna happen, boo-boo. So you have to establish your boundaries, newbies, what you're willing to do and what you're not willing to do, and stand up and believe in whatever it is you believe in. You know, I haven't always been this way. I used to be shy at one time. believe it or not. Yeah, I was. Got over that quickly. So, you know, just like your price, just like your products, just like how many ever hours it's going to take you to make something. Just be honest and upfront about it. Because you know what? Nobody wants to be lied to. Nobody wants to. I don't want to hear. Well, blah, 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 blah. Oh, that brings me to my next point. Thank you. Oh, gosh. Like the last 20 people that sent me money, thank you for that. Thank you for being patient. I got to tell you, because you know how I work. If the spirit, who's the real decorator, not Tosh, okay, doesn't give me a design. Let me check my 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay, make sure I got everything. That's the other thing. Got to make sure you have everything. Which is another good reason to have, to leave everything, all those PayPal notices, all those Etsy notices, keep them in. So I used to, when I bought $500 worth of stuff a month, I would move that over to ordered. I called the folder on my IncrediMail ordered. So as soon as it came, as soon as I hit send, pay, I get the ones from PayPal, which I would not keep. The ones that said, what do they say? It'll say your latest transaction or something. Your Etsy order. No. Your Etsy purchase. That's it. Your Etsy purchase. I would move those over to ordered. And then when I got it, I would go in, make sure they match, and then delete. Delete, 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 delete. Okay? But if you don't do good business, don't you think that's going to spread? Now, don't get me wrong. In 12 years, I have had 2 complaints. And in 12 years, they weren't my fault. I told you they're natural crystals. They might break if you drop them. The other one was, you know, when you have something like this, excuse me, you either buy or make your own eye pins. That's an eye pin, okay? You see how the loop is right there? You can see it. Sometimes you have something and then you open the loop, you put it in, you close the loop, and sometimes it comes apart. That's what happened. Just to be honest, okay? One other guy did mention that his crystal cracked. And, you know, again, I didn't mail it cracked. So, and you know, I pad all my stuff well, okay? I would use all of this for one little tiny size 4 ring, okay? Yeah, ring. Yeah, I'm going to sell that one, by the way, okay? And then, you know me, I'm sorry. If you want pretty packaging, I'll be happy to raise the price. Most women don't care. Where's my little fruit cups? See, I already put them away. Little tiny fruit cups that you give your kids. Yeah, save those. And see, I wrap that up in that bubble wrap. I put it in there. And then I will take my... Hello Kitty tape. And put on top. So it does not move. I make sure nothing moves. Okay? So you just gotta, you know, just be honest with yourself. Because you can't start out, you know, one way now and then change later. Other than my prices go up $10 every year. And considering my prices are lower than anybody's in my field for the type of jewelry I make. In my field, I'm the lowest price one, and I make sure that I'm not gouging people or anything like that, you know, because that's not good juju. Sorry, I've been watching Garden in the Good of Evil and Good, and you know what I mean. Almost every night, because it just puts me in such a... Yeah, anyway, so you have to really pay attention to those things. So, moving on. Oh, and you have to say something, okay? So even though I have ran into 4 stores, I never got my product. 3 of those stores didn't even exist. Yeah, it was just a front. See, and again, I'm reminding myself, that's why I'm going to start a blacklist for Etsy. For those people like that. I mean, hey, that was $50. That's a lot of money to me. Before, you know, when I had a job and I was making, what, I don't know, $18, $19 an hour, whatever. And that was my lowest paying job. It wouldn't, you know, bother me nearly as much as me not making that now. So, you have to be really cautious and careful, and you have to not be afraid to say whatever it is you feel like saying or doing. You know, this one guy got so smart with me in a personal message, you know, and I, honey, please, I will print screen that stuff. Yeah, because I don't know what Etsy does with it after I start a case. So I started a case. Anyway, I started the case, and I eventually got my things because he wasn't sending my money back, you know. Oh, please, that's not going to happen, okay? It's just not going down like that, boo-boo. It isn't. Because, honey, I will put your goddamn name on everything. You know, how many different social sites are there? 172,000? Yeah, I'd put them on each and every one. Yes, I would. You don't play with people's money. You don't play with people's children, relationships, food, you know, silly things like that. And you surely do not play with mine. Big Mama don't go down like that. Oh, by the way, that's not a size thing. It's an honor thing, just for those of you out there that don't know that yet. Anyway, keep it pushing. So, I'm serious. I really want to start a thing so that you cannot lose your money. And even go so far as to put the Etsy stores that you have had good shopping experiences with, like hers. She would be like the first one I would put there as an excellent, excellent business owner. You know, her and Lynn from Supply and Design. That's who I get my wire from, you know. Always on time, every time. And if she don't have it, I will just write to her, Lynn, do you have, you know, half round silver wire? Nope, but I'll get it for you. I forgot I asked her. She says, how many do you want? I said, how many what? How many half silvers? I said, oh wow, I'll take 3. Okay. You know, and you just do good business to get good business, just like anything else in life. Some people call it karma. I just call it good business. Because I don't worry about what if, and if I, and you're going to get that back, and you're going, I don't measure stuff like that. That's a waste of energy. So I just do good all the time. There was something else I was going to tell you, but I was so excited today I didn't write it down. Sorry. So let's keep it pushing. So I got all my stuff. Now I can go to her thing, and I hate now that Etsy makes us wait. We have to wait till November 25th to give a feedback thing. Anyways, so today I got a package of goodies from my brother. So let's show you these in the little barrel thing first. That beautiful. That is, where's my glasses? Topaz. I know. But if my brother were here, he would give you the exact scientific name, and that's just how he is. We're born the same day, about 10 years apart, I think. He's so wonderful. Topaz from Brazil. Oops. Is that not gorgeous? Is that not gorgeous? And all of these are VVS or IF. That is flawless. You know, so in the store, they would sell this to you probably for about $900. Yeah, not Tosh. Just saying. And next. Isn't it exciting? I told one of my other suppliers, I said, wow, you must feel like this every day. He says, yeah, I do. Another type of topaz. Oops, where am I going? Can you see that? A little. Well, go to Facebook, Tasha L. Harris, all one word. And you'll see him there. Now, this is citrine. Can you believe this is a citrine? Well, I can, but I imagine not many of you knew that there's like 3 or 4 different types of citrine. I'm thinking about keeping that one for myself if Priestess Sherry doesn't want it. Moonstone. Fluorite, right? No, this is different. Smoky. VVS quality. I love seeing that. Isn't that gorgeous? Mmm. Oh, this is the fluorite one. Just heaven. I love it. What have we here? Oh, yeah. I'm thinking you guys won't get this one either. Smoky. Isn't that gorgeous? Wow. VVS. Clarity. Quality. What's this one? Oh, quartz. Oh, sorry. There. Oh yeah, prenite. That's right. It's gorgeous. Don't that look like candy? And then of course the little baby zizzizzizzizz braillets. Sapphire braillets. VS. Second best quality. They're so cute, but they're so tiny. I'm thinking I'm just going to stick them to some clay something or another. Okay, newbies, that's about it for this video. Oh, and don't forget, you know, you don't have to have all the prettiest and best. You know, a lot of us, when we finally love something, you go so far out of your way to get every little thing. My first thing to tell you about that is go to the thrift store first. Smudge it before you bring it back in the house, because, you know, there'd be... Well, I believe that there's entities on things when you bring them back through your house. So you always got to smudge, I feel. And I'm going to actually try to put all my stuff away right now for the first time in a long time, because it makes me feel more creative when I have a desk full of stuff. I can look at one piece and go, oh, you know, I think I should do this with that. And if it's not on my desk, I'm not going to think to say that, you know. But I am going to do right now is put my beads away. Right now. Okay, that's for her, so I need to leave that there. And then I'm going to put these in the appropriate boxes that I got for $5 from, what's that hardware store? Harbor Freight, yeah. When they do have a sale, I just go there. And you get the big, huge bin things like for mechanics. What is that? That's probably, oh, I don't know, like 2 feet wide and 1.5 feet tall and about 4 inches deep. That holds a lot. So, you know, back when I got that one for, I really think I only paid $10 for it. It ain't pretty, but it holds stuff. So if I know I'm gonna go spend the night over somebody's house or go out of town for the weekend or whatever, I just grab that and my other bag, which is already packed, because now, well, let me show you the thing that I got at Walmart. I don't think I shooed you guys before. $5. $5. See, it's so big, it won't even all fit in the camera. And then inside I have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 3-4 boxes, and then the rest of it is empty space for my round wire and my pliers and stuff, which I put wire and then bubble wrap and then my pliers and then bubble wrap and then whatever and then bubble wrap, so nothing is ever like bumping and touching and stuff. And that is in my tote bag with a separate set of pliers, always ready to go, always, because a girl just never knows when she's going to go out the house and need to sit in the car, because, you know, I don't do that shopping like other women. I don't. Well, unless we're going bead shopping, that's different. Also, you know, I don't want to show you that, but those little things that you eat out of, or, you know, so you order food and it comes in those little plastic containers. Yeah. Yeah, yeah. So that's good for storage as well as shipping, because like I was saying earlier, it just ain't pretty no more, folks. I'm getting back there, though. I'm getting back there. You know, you just got to cut costs at some point when you really can't afford the pretty tissue and paper and all that good stuff and the cute little thank you notes, you know, stuff like that. So until I get back there, I mean, I could just raise the prices, but I don't feel that's fair either. You know, I just don't. So just like chain, you guys need to realize if rarely is there a chain in any picture I have, because I had an actual customer tell me, well, it's in the picture. And she was right. So I stopped putting chain in the pictures. Sometimes I have it and sometimes I don't. I don't want to have to remember if I don't have it and it's in the picture. So forget it. If I have chain, I will tell you in a personal message. I have, you know, this little 18-inch piece of chain that I'm going to gift you with your... And you're like, gift me? Yeah. You're not paying for chain. You're paying for my 5 hours it took to make that thing. I mean, even yesterday, it took me, I think, once I finally stopped talking to everybody else... No offense. And make the ring. I think it took me probably 3 hours to make this ring. And, you know, that's how most people that make handmade things charge, by the hour. Not some of them don't even charge according to the ingredients. Just an hourly time. And then other people charge for the products and the service time. And tax and PayPal fees. And shipping. Yes. So when I tell you, you know, postage, I have to be honest, postage is only $5.70, priority 3-day mail. I charge you $6 because when you give me $5.70, PayPal takes out that 70 cents, then I don't have postage, huh? So yes, sorry, I have to charge you PayPal fees. If I just don't have the money in PayPal, which is pretty much the only way I shop, that way you have record of everything. Yes, it's a good thing. And for my customers listening, please put your address in PayPal. It would make life so much easier. So when I have my phone, it goes bling, and I look and I see that P. Aha, I have money. And then like 2 minutes later, bling, that's email. Oh, I got money. Okay. And even from the phone, I can say, go ahead and make me a label. I get to PayPal at home and I just print up the label. It makes it so much easier for us if you could do that, you know? Just put your name on there. Nobody's going to know what your address is but me, you, and PayPal. And I'm not about to go giving nobody's business out on the street. That's not right. So anyway, you know, you have all these little bitty things to think about as you progress in your career, you know? And let me just be a little hard on you right now. Stop saying it's a hobby. Don't expect people to buy your shit if it's a hobby. If it's a hobby, it'll pay you like a hobby. Who did I get that from? I think that was Skip Ross way back in 1987, 88. Oh, that was a good guy. I like him. Anyway, you know, he's right, though. If you treat it like a hobby, it'll pay you like a hobby. Do you get paid from hobbies? I'm sorry, what? Crickets. Okay. Yeah. Anyway, you think about that. Let that marinate later. So, you know, when you do good business and you just tell people nicely, you know, Tosh, I thought I was getting blah, 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 and it looks kind of like this. See, but that's why I'm here to tell you now. I try to reinforce this every step of the way. And sometimes I don't care how much money you're offering me. If my spirit guides, my ancestors tell me not to do something, I don't care about your money. It's just ethics. It's ethics, you know? As a kid, you do things your parents tell you not to do, and you always get your butt beat, right? Well, we did. So I'd rather just not have any confusion and just do what I know is right for me. 'Cause forget you. You're not going to be the one sitting up at night stressing and worrying and trying to get this done. And I've been working on it for, I think, 4 days now. It didn't even take me this long to make that Eye of Horus. But see, it's long so that I can twist it around that way, go behind, twirl it, and, you know, yeah. It'll get there. But yeah, you have to, you know, back up your stuff. Because if you can't back up yourself and speak for yourself, well, I'm new. That's got nothing to do with that $10 bracelet that I wanted to get. I don't care if you're new. Does it come in this color, that flavor, this size? That's got nothing to do with being new. It's got everything to do with you knowing your stock on hand. You know, until you get like half this room, it's only 8 by 10, full of, you know, more crystals than my big behind could carry, you know? So, and it's just like being any other type of entertainer. People are like, oh, did you make that? Let me see. And you have to do it if you believe in yourself. Right now, you say, oh, this is agate. That's not agate. That's howlite. That's not even turquoise. That's howlite. It's dyed howlite to look like turquoise. You notice the texture in this and this and this. Just like, you know, I really, really want to go to GIA for pearls. I want to be a pearlologist, honey. Yes, I do. Because I love me some pearls, honey. So I know already there's like 10 different kinds of pearls. The most expensive is Tahitian pearls. They're dark and they have to go... Well, you can YouTube it. Sorry, I'm not going to get all into that. But my favorite would be Tahitian pearls and those nice big fat potato pearls that are like this big. Oh, they're just so yummy. Anyway, and you have to be able to talk to people, get your point across without hurting anybody's feelings. I'm, you know, soon to be 55. I don't care about hurting your feelings. What you want is this and this and this. I don't make a lot of sterling stuff, because sterling doesn't have a lot of healing properties. I just don't. However, if you want to pay the extra $45-$50 bucks for sterling, I'd be happy to go buy some sterling for you. I ain't got no beef with that. But I find it, what's the word? When you go to buy a piece of jewelry and you said for healing purposes and then you ask for sterling, to me that's just backwards. But that's just me. I don't pay your rent. So hey, you can offer me an extra $25 for sterling. I'll go buy some for Rio Grande. I'll make your product. I'll bless your product just like I do everything else and ship it out to you, and you're going to be happy camper because it's nice and pretty and shiny. OG. Now, maybe I could study, is there such a thing as a... Well, because the wire I use has a very thin film of sterling, but it's copper core, see? Okay, and there's a sterling with copper core and everything. Let's see. See? Had I never made this video for you guys, I would not have known that. But anyway, I'm happy with Lynn and the wire that I've been getting from her from I don't know how many years. So, yeah, I'll leave that on the site. I mean, I'll update the site now. But anyway, it's still the same, because this is not the same price I pay for wire. So I will study that, and if you want, I will be happy to go out and buy that for you. But in any case, it's just like anything else in life. It's just like having a baby. You don't know until you know. And by then, you would have bought 10 sets of pliers. Too many boxes that don't fit in your purse. Because, you know, so we first started out little cigar boxes, and you got two pair of pliers, and you got some beads, and you got some wire, and then that's it. And then it grows and grows, and you're just like purses. You know. So, hey, each one teach one, you know. You don't always have to have the most expensive and go to the most expensive places. You can go to the thrift store and buy some bags that somebody got, and they made a mistake or whatever, and they got the wrong supply bags. What do you do? Oh, at their own giveaway to thrift store. Okay, yeah. You know, same with leather thongs and shoestrings. A lot of people make jewelry out of shoestrings now. Don't turn up your nose now. Okay, I think that's about it. So you're going to find those gems, if you want to buy any, on Facebook, Tasha L. Harris, all one word. And in the meantime and in between time, this is my latest clay baby. And I'm very happy to say, I'm pretty happy with this piece. I'm going to add more to it, but I'm pretty happy with it. That's the front. That's the back. So now tonight I'm going to make some little snaky things to go in the front. And maybe cover up that little piece right there that looks like a penis. See? Yeah, because I didn't want to handle it too much while it was wet. But tonight I'm going to wrap it first, smooth it, so there's no point on its head. Then I'm going to let it dry a little teeny bit. Then I'm going to wrap my stamp around it. Then let it get hard. Stick that back in some plumber's clay. You know, plumber's clay holds stuff, newbies. Yeah, so I'm sure you're... And it's cheap, so don't go thinking I would ever necessarily tell you to buy anything expensive except pliers. And there's woobers. And there's another name that I cannot think right now. Where's my plumber's clay? And that's because each one has a money-back guarantee. And they're ergonomic. So, you know, for elderly people, your hands aren't going to be cramping up. You're not going to be hurting your arthritis. I mean, you know what I mean. Making it worse. Okay, I can't find it. So, yeah, you Google that. Google some plumber's clay. And see, just as soon as I said that. So, you know, when you go to a lot of gym sites, they have the gem stuck on something. I don't know what theirs is, but Tasha just uses plumber's clay. I don't know what plumbers use it for either, so don't ask. I don't know. I don't care. I know I use it. To hold stuff. Yeah. And you get a big tub of this shit for like 99 cents. Yeah, it's just like fish wire. You know, you get 5,000 bazillion yards of fish cord. Literally, the stuff you catch a fish with. Go to your store, go to the hunting, fishing section, and get you a big-ass, huge roll of fishing cord stuff to make your necklaces and bracelets with. Yes. And let's put this back and get ready to wrap it up. Kind of sort of remembered all the questions that people have asked me this week. And just like your clay, you got to keep it wrapped tight. So there you have it. There it be. I don't think there was anything else I wanted to tell you. But you could look at my beautiful baby that I just finally finished. Oh, wow. Now I want to get some smaller ones of these because I have little bits of aqua aura and orange aura. It was probably just a half an inch tall, and I want to put one of these on them. Isn't that gorgeous? Guess what that is? Yep, it's a bead cap. It's a bead cap. See, you put the bead up in there. Yeah. Isn't that amazing? It's such a wonderful idea. And I don't remember where I saw that from. Online, in a book, whatever. I don't know, umpteen years ago. So you guys, go be good to yourself. I love you. Have a good day. I will put her shop link on the video as soon as it loads. Yadana, Yadanabeads, all together. I love you. Mwah. Go be good to yourself, and I'll see you online. Bye.